Thank you. Thank you for being here. And I suppose you are interested in knowing what happens in Parma every year in the month of October. I have to say that the festival starts the last weekend of September and goes for almost a month, for 4 weekends, during which we propose to our public, which is mostly an international public, 4 new productions every year that take place in 4 days in 3 different venues. So it's a big effort for Teatro Reggio, and everything is done under the name of Verdi, that is the musician that we want to celebrate. But today is a special year for the festival because it will be the 18th edition. This means that Festival Verdi becomes, as we say in Italian, maggiorenne, so becomes adult, and is the right time to consider where we are with the festival. And how do we consider the state of the health of an event like a monographic festival? We consider numbers and also quality. Numbers tells us in the that in the last 3 years we really jumped, we made a big jump. We almost we had 250% of increase of the public. We know that last year 2/3 of this public, almost 63%, came on purpose to Parma to attend the performances of Festival Verdi. We had a big result also in terms of sponsorship. So the number seems to give us a good message. The festival is in good health. But what about quality? That is a little bit more difficult because, of course, for me, it's the best possible festival, but this would not, you know, it's so easy for those who put their passion, their work, their heart in a project. It's very easy to say that it's the best possible project, but just 1 week ago, we received a fantastic news, which is that for the edition 2017, the festival has gained 3 nominations for the International Opera Awards, which are, how can I say, the Oscar for the opera. And we gained a nomination as Best Festival in Europe for 2017, and we compete with Salzburg Festival and with Bayreuth Festival. We had a nomination as Best Production with Stiffelio that took place at the Teatro Farnese last year. And also we gained a nomination as Best Young Interpreter, which debuted at the festival. Her name is Isabella Lee, and she was the main interpreter of La Traviata that has been produced in Busseto. So, of course, we are very enthusiastic about this news because the idea that gives us that the festival is really in good shape, and this is not an arrival point, but a starting point from which keep building the reputation and the project for a Festival Verdi. But why we do Festival Verdi? As you may know, Verdi is the most performed composer in the world. The Performing Society tells us that every year 1,200,000 tickets are sold to attend performances of Verdi operas. And also they say that the most performed title is La Traviata, with more than 15,000 performances every year. So we may say that the entire opera world is a Verdi festival all through the year. So why do we need to have a festival that celebrates especially this great composer? Because there is a big difference in listening, we believe, Verdi's music in the land of Verdi. And Parma is very close by to Busseto, which is the tiny little town where Verdi was. And there are many flavors, many memories of this great composer, who suggested us to dedicate a festival to him. And we also decided to start a philological itinerary, so we will perform, and we already do it, scores that are in critical edition. I quickly try to tell you what is a critical edition. It's like restoring a painting when we, with the Casa Editrice Ricordi and with a scientific committee which is composed by five important professors specialized in Verdi's music. They try to give back the version of the score that is as much as possible close to the original, because you may know that during the century the music has been cut by the conductor, by singers. You know that Verdi was not very happy with the church, so some of the subject has been modified because of the, you may have with censura, how do we say censura?
Censorship.
Yeah. Because it was against the moral of that period. So we try to give back the original shape to the scores of Verdi, and so why we propose all the titles in critical edition. We made a new publication that is called Verdi Festival Verdi Journal, which is not for specialists, but helps all the people coming to attend the festival to get into the mood of the four titles that we propose. And then we have a new musical director, we are very proud of it, which is Roberto Abbado, which is a great Verdi interpreter. And now we are ready to tell something about the program. Dates. The festival takes place in Parc del Busseto from September 27th to October 21st. You know what is Parma, so there is no need, but anyway, it's halfway between Milano and Bologna, two big airports, so it's easy to reach Parma. This is the Teatro Regio, it's our main house, a beautiful house, I guess, in perfect shape, and I'm glad to, it has been inaugurated in 1829, and has 1,150 seats, not bad. But we do have a second location, a very smart and incredible location, which is the Teatro Farnese. Now, Teatro Farnese was built, you will not believe it, to celebrate a wedding, and it was supposed that after the wedding it would have been destroyed. Luckily they didn't. And so we have an old lady in perfect shape, it has almost 400 years. And today it's not used as a theater, it's part of a museal itinerary. So you to go to, it is in the Complesso Monumentale della Pilota, on the right hand side there is the Galleria Palatina that has a wonderful painting collection. On the left hand side there is a wonderful library, old library that has manuscripts and very incredible things. So we decided that during the festival this comes back to its function as a theater instead of a segment of a museal itinerary. And since I thought that would have been a good idea to give a special meaning to each one of the three locations, of course the two of the four productions takes place at the Teatro Regio and are, how can I say, not traditional but more institutional. The Teatro Farnese is the place where we do propose innovative productions, and this has been the place that hosted the last year the Steve Fellio, who gained the nomination, what I was telling you before. And the third location, this is a detail, you can see how beautiful it is, it's very big, there are 70 meters from the entrance to the stage, so really huge. And then the third location is this one. This one is the Teatro Verdi in Busseto. Now let me tell you something about this space, because it's very special. Verdi was born very close by, and this theater is part of again a monumental building. On the left hand side there is the office of the mayor. On the right hand side, looking at the facade, there is the theater. And this theater has been built while Verdi was still alive. And Verdi at that time was very old and very rich and very generous. Not very old, not young anymore, but rich enough and very generous. So the people from Busseto went and asked him to support the cost for the cost of the building. And he did not say no. Gave them 10,000 lire, which was quite a huge amount of money for that time. But he was not happy because the theater was too small. Because he had an experience, you know, big theaters all over the world, and he could not see that in a small town, Busseto today has 7,000 people living. So how could he think that Busseto could have had a 1,000 seat theater? But anyway, he supported the people who decided to build it, but he didn't attend the inaugural performance to protest against the size of the theater, which today has his name. And in front of the theater, on the opposite side of the square, there is Casa Barezzi, which is the house where he studied, because Barezzi was the mecenate who helped him, who came from a very poor family, to become Verdi, because he paid for his study. And in front of the theater, on the opposite side of the house, there is Casa Barezzi, where you can still find his piano, the living room, and Verdi then married, the first wife was the daughter of Barezzi, and then she unfortunately died. So he then married Giuseppina Scarponi, as you may know. One last thing. This little piece of jewelry we write 300 seats. Well, it's not true. We maximum can seat 280. And it has a wonderful acoustic, just perfect. And you have a special feeling sitting there. The stalls have only 70 seats. And you feel like having a big privilege when you attend an opera performance with a stage that is no bigger than my living room. So it's really a special place. And the vocation of this place is to host performances and production with young interpreters, because since Busseto was the birthplace of Verdi, I thought it could have been a good idea to host the performances of the interpreters of tomorrow for Verdi's opera. So tradition at the Reggio, innovation at the Teatro Farnese, young people at Busseto. And this is the building, and on that side is hidden the theater, and was signed the mayor has his bureau. Now the program. The first performance, the inaugural performance, is Macbeth. Macbeth will be conducted by Philippe Auguin, and the production is signed by Daniele Abbado. Sets are by Graziano Gregori, costume Carla Tetti, and lighting Angelo Linsalata. But let me tell you something about the main roles. Macbeth is Luca Salsi, Lady Macbeth Anna Pirozzi, and for one performance Davinia Rodriguez. Banco is Michele Pertusi, and Macduff is Vincenzo Costanzo. The two performances at the Teatro Regio have the orchestra, the Filarmonica Arturo Toscanini, and the coro del Teatro Regio. Second performance in the calendar is a Teatro Verdi di Busseto, and is Un Giorno di Regno. Actually, it is a production that has been made for the Teatro Regio, but it is impossible to transfer it in the Teatro Verdi di Busseto, so we are going to reinvent it for this space, and the director in charge is Massimo Gasparonda, that will make a new production from the original production signed by Pierluigi Pizzi. The conductor is Francesco Pasqualetti. We do not have the name of the interpreters, which will be selected after the Concorso Internazionale delle Voci Verdiane, which takes place every year in the month of June in Busseto, and among the winners we select the interpreters of this production, and some of them are selected between the students of the Accademia Verdiana. The orchestra and chorus for the production that takes place in Busseto and also for the production that takes place at the Teatro Farnese are Orchestra e Coro del Teatro Comunale di Bologna. Third title is Les Trouvères. One of the goals of the festival is to propose titles or version of a title which are not easy to be proposed somewhere else. And we all know that Il Trovatore is one of the most famous pieces, opera signed of Giuseppe Verdi, but we do know that he also wrote a French version, is a grand opera version with some ballet, and we are glad to propose it in, also in the critical edition. And the conductor is our musical director, Roberto Abado, and the concept direction, set and lighting designer is Bob Wilson. Now, the main interpreters are Leonora is Roberta Mantegna, Zucena is Nino Ciurculanz, Ines is Tonia Langelli, Antonio is Stefano Secco, Le Comte de Luna is Franco Vassallo, Fernandes Marco Spock. Last production, Attila. Again, one title which is not so well known, but is a beautiful piece of music, is Attila. The conductor will be Gianluigi Gelmetti and the director will be Andrea De Rosa. Riccardo Zanellato will sing the main role of Attila. Maria José Siri will be Odabella. Ezio will be interpreted by Vladimir Stoyanov, and Francesco De Muro will sing the role of Foresto. Set will be of signed by Aurelio Colombo, costumes Alessandro Lai, Pasquale Mari. Now, this is the program of the four titles, again, that will take place in 4 days, so that the people who come from abroad to attend the performances of Festival Verdi can stay 4 days and see the four performances. It's a big effort we do, because to prepare, we have here in, some colleagues, and you can imagine what means bringing together to the debut four performances. But this is a festival, and we do our best to give the possibility to those who come on purpose to attend Festival Verdi to see as much as they can. But the festival is not only made of four titles of opera, we also have Mezzogiorno in Musica. Mezzogiorno in Musica has six concerts, only 50 minutes of music before lunchtime. So it's a time, we also call them concerti aperitivo, because after that you can have a glass of wine and some finger food. And you know that Parma is quite famous for food, so it's a good location to taste and see if it's true what people knows, you know, about the food in Parma, in gastronomy in general. But the purpose is also to give the occasion of seeing another venue in the heart of town, just in front of the Pilote. There is Palazzo Ducale, surrounded by the Giardino Ducale, and on the first floor, that we call Piano Nobile, there are wonderful, wonderful sale, hall, and we accompany our public in an itinerary, and we also cross the central sala, which is il Salone degli Uccelli, that has, now I don't know how to explain, the ceiling is a botte, has this shape, and is decorated by 276 little sculpture. Each one describes a special, a different kind of birds, una specie mitologica. Is something unbelievable. And so why we decided to propose here Mezzogiorno in Musica, because people have the opportunity to discover another space that is usually not open to the public. So music, but something else around music. Then, of course, the 10th of October is the birthday of Giuseppe Verdi, so we do a big ceremony, and in the evening we have a gala verdiano, and it ends with a big toast with all the public in the theater, a toast with the Bonarda, that was the wine that Verdi loved most, you know, between those produced in our territory. We have a symphonic concert with the Orchestra Giovanile in Busseto, and then another concert in Teatro Regio with the orchestra and chorus, the best choral pages by Verdi, but also by Rossini, because today is a special year for Rossini, it's an important anniversary, and also around those composers, Meyerbeer and Donizetti. We do have the International Friends, who is an association that we started last year. But let me, we do not have one more slide. We have another festival in parallel that goes on, and it is called Verdi Off. Now, what is Verdi Off? We decided that in the root of the word festival, there is the meaning of a big festa. And we want that everyone can participate to this festa under the name of Verdi. And we want to invite and include also those who are not passionate with opera, also those who would never buy a ticket or cannot afford to buy a ticket, or those who are temporarily have no possibility to participate. And so there is a social path. We go to the jail. And last year we made a chorus with the prisoners, and we did a shortest version of La Traviata, and the chorus was made of prisoners. And I can tell you, it was an experience. To me, it was really something astonishing. Then we went to the hospital with the little kids, bringing a little Falstaff with marionette, and a chorus made with the children who were singing for the children that were in the hospital during the festival. Then we went to the retirement houses where people, probably some of them were part of our public, and now they cannot attend anymore, they cannot leave their retirement house. So we brought a little piece of the festival to them. But much more happens in the street, in the square, in the private house. We asked the Parnassian, all those who have a living room with a piano. Doesn't matter if it's an elegant house or it's a simple house. Doesn't matter if it's a big living room or just a small living room. But if they are happy, they send us their availability and we program some concert, simple concert, a recital for piano, and voice or a quartet with the transcription of Verdi music. And we go in this house and they host people who make a reservation. This, all Verdi Off events are free, no tickets. And so these people open their doors and host all the music lovers who come for the festival, and the public has the opportunity to get into a private house, which is quite an experience. You never do when you travel. You go in a hotel, you go in a restaurant, and after this 1 hour music, the owners offer a glass of wine and a piece of parmigiano and make friendship, you know, ask where they come from, and ask a question to the owners. It's really an important message, because music is inclusion, means being open-minded, means being, you know, generous, and means hospitality, the sense of hospitality. But we also open a window a window of the theater, every day at 1:00. And there is a singer that sings scenario for the people in the street. So after the first, the second, the third day, there was a group of people waiting. And actually, we had to change windows because the traffic was stopped, and the municipality was not so happy. And then we had, we went on the sul greto del fiume. How do you say greto? The bed of well, the river. I don't know. The river bed, which is dry in October because it's a small river that takes the water from the rain, so in October it's dry. And we do comic opera, so Verdi's opera in a comic version for the people who are there at that moment. We go in the park before the sun rays and we do a concert. And slightly the sun arrives, and it's an important moment, it's the main part of the town. So all strange things, but the message is that the music is not only inside the institutional location, but the music can invade a town during the period of the festival, and whoever comes to Parma in the month of October has the feeling and the flavor of the festival, of the music, of the food, of an experience. This is what we want to offer to the public who comes to Parma for Festival Verdi. So I hope I've been, you know, not talking too much. But if there is some hero who wants to know more, I'm happy to answer to a question. Thank you very much.